Hello, my name is Victoria Jampolsky. I'm the president and founder of the Startup Station, and this is our weekly strategic finance tips. So in this video, we're going to talk about unit economics. How do you know if your unit economics makes sense? But before we dive into that, let's understand what it is. What is unit economics, right? And so the unit economics refers to direct revenues and costs per one customer. Essentially, it's any metric per one customer, right? And so why is it important, right? Let's understand why you need to really pay attention to it. Well, first, it can tell you if you make more money from a customer than spend on acquisition, right? This is a very important analysis. If you find out after performing this analysis that it costs you more money to acquire a customer than you can make from it, then there's something fundamentally wrong in your business model, because it's not sustainable, right? It's not built in a way where you can make money long-term. Not only should you make money from a customer, you should make at least as much money as what is accepted by your industry. And also your acquisition costs should decrease with time, right? Definitely not increase. Second point. It can tell you how quickly you can grow your business, right? Because how much money you make per customer, which is called the contribution margin, affects how much cash is generated by operations, right? So how much money you have to invest in your business. And yes, of course, you're going to go for growth rounds and get external capital to fuel your growth. That is possible for some companies. For others, they may just need internally generated cash flow in order to scale. So it is important to understand how much help you can get from your operations directly. Third point, it can inform you if it makes sense to acquire more customers, right? Because sometimes, of course, you need a certain customer base, but sometimes if the acquisition cost or sales cycles are too long and the costs are too high, it may not make sense to acquire more customers, but focus more on upselling existing customers and building a really beneficial relationship with them. So this analysis is really important because it affects how you think about your company's growth, how you think about where your company can go and how quickly it can get there. And finally, and very importantly, right? And that's a point I mentioned when we discussed the very first point, it can tell you if you're building a sustainable business. If you find that your analysis produces negative numbers, the acquisition costs are increasing, you can't really grow, it means that you need to rethink your business model. And you don't need to try anything, right, to find that out. If you are building a plan and you find out that this plan is bad, you don't need to execute on the plan to confirm it. You can just change it right away, right? Because you should only execute on the plan when it's a good one. And that is the reason why people should build financial models, is to make sure that whatever they're planning to execute on makes sense financially, that they're not trying to do something which is just outright wrong. And so in the end, it's not about what makes sense, right, per se, or what doesn't make sense. Your unit economics makes sense, right? In which case, when it allows you to reach your cash flow goals or your valuation goals on your desired timeline, right? That is when you have the fundamental building blocks of your business model, which are in your favor. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please share with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more very useful videos every Tuesday, and follow us on social media. If you want to learn how to build credible financials, please sign up to our free masterclass, Build Credible Financials for Your Venture. The link is in the description. Thank you again, and see you next week.